Hello guys, welcome to another one of my Soda Dungeon videos. I'm going to be showcasing something pretty cool in this video, I think so anyway, and it is the Reaper legendary weapon. You can see it being held right here. I'm going to show you guys the stats for it a bit later. What I'm going to start out by showing you is the drawback of the weapon. The Reaper weapon has a 20% chance of taking out your opponent every time you strike, no matter how strong they are, 20% chance to take them out. It has been working like a charm, but apparently it does not work on the level 100, 200, 300 bosses, it only deals its base damage. I've been using it to farm because it's just insane, like completely, and then I ran into to this chick here, and I think this battle here took more than 10 minutes of this stuff here going on. So this video here today is mostly high speed because I wanted to showcase the Reaper and its crazy effect, both in the boss battle here, but also in a bit of a grinding streak afterwards, showing you the type of loot that you get in this part of the game. And before doing that, just scooping down here, this is like 50 levels of grinding. Yeah, dragon armor, two of those, photon blade, shield of Quinix, you know, legendaries all over the freaking place. After you hit level 1000, you do not need chance to find items anymore. By the way, up here, imaginary friends is what it says. It is no copyright sounds. I kind of scooped a bit of the media player feed. But anyway, it is no copyright sounds throughout the entire video. In this setup here, the grinding I'm going to be doing, I am using the Skeletus armor. The dragon is better, but the Skeletus is the first you're going to be getting. 25% damage reduction. The Reaper, 20% chance to instantly kill your opponent. 5 people going with that. Having the Skeletus armor, meaning they take less damage. But that's not all. We're gonna boost these. This is like the first version of a legendary grind immortality kind of team. Using the dragon shield as well, because it makes you immune to status effects. That's freezing, no, it's poison, it's burning, it's sleeping. Femora's feather, 20% damage reduction, 5% evade, 2 of those, meaning that we're looking at 65% damage reduction. We could go lower with the meat shield and go all the way up to 70, but I do like the dragon one better. So we're taking only a third of the damage that is being dealt to us, and we're pushing back with the dragon shield damage if they hit us, based on the original damage, meaning that if they hit us, they're gonna get nasty pants back, and we're not really gonna be taking that much damage. So taking this team here, after just scooping up my Constitution Cola a little bit more into the part of the dungeon in Dimension 3 that I reached when I recorded this, just to show you guys insanity. This is the Reaper in action, failing. Oh yeah, there it didn't. There it didn't. It's like ding, 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 boom. So the theory, the concept of this setup here, I have better. But when I made this, this was my first go at it. But the concept is, no matter what you're hitting, it's gonna die. At some point, all else equal, in 5 hits, it's going to die. Because that is what the Reaper does, and everybody has it. So you can kill anything. You don't need high attack, a legendary drop. So no matter what you're up against, it's gonna die. And no matter what hits you, you're not gonna take much damage because we have 65% damage reduction. So I'm just going with, I mean, we have healers. Everything's gonna be good and dandy. If they deal 1000 damage to us, we're gonna be taking 350 only. That's how crazy this setup is. And we have evade options, and we have pushback damage. So this is a pretty crazy team build that I have optimized it even further. Since I speeded this grind up quite a bit, I'm just showing you guys when the different bags drop with the loot, the legendary, and the rare stuff. And what I was really curious about when I started grinding, like after level 1000, was the blue stuff. You know, the cool blue items that we know from the early part of the game. Will we see that in level 2? Is there a level 2 holy cannon? No, there is not. No, there is not. I'm sorry. It was my main hope that the early legendaries would come level 2. The early rares would come level 2. But they're not. Meaning that we're getting them all the time now. And they're junk. Because we got them like 1000 levels ago. We don't need them anymore. So it looks pretty impressive that we're getting rares all the time. We're getting legendaries all the time. But let's face it, you don't hit level 1000 or level 1200 without having these items already. So for the first time in my entire almost a week of Soda Dungeon Gaming, I was a bit disappointed because I was expecting the progression to continue indefinitely. But I had hope still. I was hoping to see at least the gray items increase, you know? So we have the ninja outfit. Can we get that level 25? What about, you know, the spike shield? Can we get that level 100? So far, my stats say no. Level 10 is what it is capped at, based on what I have seen in the game so far. It does not mean that it isn't possible, but I have not yet seen items above level 10, which basically means that unless we get more items in later dimensions, and I'm hoping, I currently have the best I can have. Not in this group setup here, but I do have the group I'm running with. Like here. Not sure if you guys can see anything at all. Same deal, kinda. Just further ahead in the dungeon. So, showcase of the loot here. As you can see, crazy pants stuff. Legendaries all over the place, but Midas plate. Still the same, full shield, mech's garb, all those items, they're not better than they were when we got them at level 400, at level 200. So basically, I'm not getting anything new, and it doesn't really worry me because I know this is about, you know, continuous progression, but I was hoping I have a stool and a wooden sword, you know. What this basically means is that I am going to be grinding a bit more here, giving it a chance to pop out, hoping to see something amazing. If not, I'm gonna scoop to dimension 4 and hope to see new items there. If not, I'm probably gonna scoop all the way to dimension 10 and just doing my chain grinding there, because it means that the game has nothing new to offer me in the following levels, and it's just going to be about hitting the end dimension or the end level in the last dimension, and then that's what I'm going to be aiming at. So anyway guys, this was me showcasing the Reaper and the close to immortal build. Like I said, I have better going on, and I'm going to be showing it along with like when and where you can find different items. It's all coming. Crazy exam times, so yeah, a bit bumped, but it's going to be there. As always guys, thank you very much for watching.